Corridor. They're carrying this huge heavy trunk. It's the wizards. It'll be crammed full of mysteries and enchantments.
Let's go and spy on them. Who's coming?
Me.
Miss Cackle said we should wait in the classroom.
We're not going to talk to them or anything.
Just take a peek and run back.
Honestly, you'd think she'd never seen a boy in her life before.
Oh, shut up, Ethel. They're not ordinary boys, are they? They're apprentice wizards.
Yeah, no, yes, no, no.
I think we may have been mistaken about those doors being stuck.
Funny thing that, Baz. I think we might have been.
Stop gawking about, Loppy, and help us with this.
Easy.
Watch out for fingers.
Ah! You clumsy idiot!
Oh. Can't help it.
You never can. Look, you've broken his fingers.
It wasn't my fault.
He'd probably get gangrene and die.
He won't. I'm sorry, Baz. I'm really sorry.
I'm sorry, Gaz. I'm really sorry.
What was that?
Witches.
We're apprentice wizards. There's nothing they can do that we can't do 10 times better.
Says who?
Says I. Gary Grailquest. A Grenus Uprenus at Incarceratus.
Oh, what happened? Oh, get it off!
Foolish and impertinent boys! What on earth do you think you're playing at?
Oh, get it off!
Please.
Is this courtesy? Is this civility? Is this creating a good impression?
No, sir.
No, sir. Then you will now apologize to these young ladies. At once!
Sorry.
Courteous and abject apologies.
My friends and I are truly sorry for any distress which we may have caused you.
Sorry.
Truly sorry. And my friends and I are pleased to accept your apologies.
Indeed we are.
Yes.
Good gracious, we weren't expecting you quite so early, Your Honour. I hope our girls haven't been any trouble to you.
Not in the least, my dear Miss Cackle. Not in the least.
Now, is everybody ready? Mistrill?
Yes?
You'll be here in a second, Mistrill!
Hallelujah!
Mistrill will position herself in front of the door. Then, as soon as he is sighted, Fenella and Griselda will sing him our little chant of welcome. Then, Mistrill and I will greet him, and I will take him by the hand and lead him to his coffee chair and offer him a selection of traditional witch snacks from the trolley. Sun-dried iguana toes, barbecued bat's wings, spider's eggs on toast, and lemonade surprise.
It's a bit green-looking.
Fermented pond slime.
Yes, well, I'm sure it'll surprise him all right.
Rich in proteins and vitamin C. Then, whilst he unwinds from his journey, we will sit side by side and discuss matters of mutual interest.
Mr. Bat.
Miss Hardbroom.
We've been through this already. His Honour has come to give a lecture to the first and second years and to inspect their potion and spell classes, not to waste his time with snacking and small talk. Class records. The Grand Wizard and I will sit together in private whilst I talk him through them.
After he has had some rest and refreshment.
I don't know why everyone's getting so excited.
Well, he is the Grand Wizard.
Egbert Hellebore, master of magic, confidant of kings and ministers.
And a crusty old windbag.
We bid you welcome, we bid you welcome to Cackle's Academy. Behold your honour, we humbly offer our hospitality.
Charming.
Sad. Ow! Do take a seat.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. I always feel so very welcome at Cackles. Ah, delicious. But Miss Cackle tells me she's laid on tea and crumpets for two in her office. So why don't I go and munch the muffins? And you boys help yourselves to the pop and savouries.
Perhaps you'd like to see to the first years, Miss Bear. The back stairs.
Ah.
The girls are so looking forward to your talk, Your Honour. Quite breathless with expectation.
Jolly good. Kick off in the great hall in quarter of an hour.
Excuse me, miss. May we have a drink, please?
Oh, help yourselves.
They said sorry.
Yes, but it's the way they said it. Like cold porridge dripping down a dungeon wall.
Sorry. The little one was all right.
He's just their slave. We've got to be on our guard. They're planning something. I know they are.
Oh, I can still taste that green stuff.
You were lucky. Lobby's not said a word since he ate those blobs on toast. You should have gone for the barbecue bat's wings like I did. Delicious. Here, Loppy. Hold this. Keep it still.
We shouldn't be messing around with his staff, Gaz.
It's like football, Loppy. They came to spy on us, right?
Right.
That's 1-0 to them. But then we spotted them and hit them with the old handkerchief trick, right?
Right.
1-1. But then Heliborg makes us look like idiots and we have to apologise, right?
Yes, but...
That's 2-1 to them.
And then those two older girls have to sing that stupid song, to all. But one of them kicks Baz in the shins.
That's a dirty foul. And that hatchet-faced teacher tried to poison us with that horrible green stuff.
Double foul. So now we take a penalty shot. Quick, they're coming here. Sticky behind your ear.
Why me?
You got the most room for it.
In you come, girls. Take your places.
Delicious, Miss Cackle. Quite delicious.
Thank you, Your Honour.
I always perform better on a full stomach. A well-buttered crumpet does oil the larynx, you know. Where are the lads?
Setting out your things in the Great Hall, Your Honour.
Hope you don't mind them tagging along. Scallywags, all three. But I expect your little witches are no angels.
Quite.
Gives them a chance to fraternize with the enemy. As far as some of these young chaps are concerned, you'd think gals were a different species altogether.
How shall I introduce you, Your Honour? You haven't said what your talk will be about this year.
A subject of infinite excitement and interest. A history of the Grand Wizard, his power and his glory. In short, Miss Cackle, myself. Greetings, young ladies. It was not over yet. Even as I flew on my winged horse up the high mountain to the king's side, the two armies, led by rival generals, faced each other in the valley below. Oh, there's going to be a terrible slaughter, says the king. Fear not, says I. I raise my staff. My staff. It glows. A shower of sparks. Shoot forth. Take heed, I cry, my magical shout echoing through the valley. The two armies stop in their tracks. Their faces turn towards me. The moment of truth has arrived. Oh, what? You've completely stopped my flow, girl. You might as well ask your question. The soldiers stared at me, waiting for a sign. Well, is this some sort of silly game?
Put your hands down at once, girls.
Tim! What? Him with his pencil! Let me your rubber, Lord.
As if to fire, but an unearthly light
shone
from
game.
My wizard staff. And their weapons are rendered useless! No! Oh.
That Mildred Hubble is one of the most ridiculous stories I have ever heard in this office. Whatever or whoever was responsible for the shameful behavior of your class this morning, it was not this perfectly ordinary lead pencil. And as for the stupid and dangerous prank with the eraser, well, you can see the results before you.
I'm sorry, sir.
So you should be. You may not be surprised to hear, Mildred, that you will be sent to your room to work on your own for the rest of the day, out of harm's way. And you can thank the Grand Wizard that you haven't been more severely punished.
Carried away by the story, I expect. Young girls, you know, easily overexcited.
Which describes you to a T, Mildred. I should think also, before you go, you should apologize to His Honor's apprentices for making such wild accusations. Don't you, Mildred?
Yes, Miss Cackle.
3-2, 3-2, 3-2, 3-2, 3-2, 3-2, 3-2, 3-2.
Oh, Millie, look at them. My hand just shut up on its own, and mine, and then I couldn't open my mouth.
Neither could I.
Typical wizardry, if you ask me.
Yes, but it didn't need Mad Millie to start pelting rubbers at Hellebore.
She always goes to extremes.
Ethel.
Excuse me, girls. Fenella, Griselda, remember you're serving lunch in the staff room. And perhaps you'd like to show our young guests where to get theirs.
Why not? They look like they could do with some nutritious school food. What's on today, Maud?
A Cackle's classic. Islands of overboiled cabbage and corpse-grey liver floating in a cold sewage of greasy gravy.
What about a double helping for our guests?
Instead of the usual stuff this afternoon, how about a war of words? A big debate with my lads. Nothing too formal. Welcome to the question why. Today we examine the question, why are wizards more important than witches? That should get them going.
Perhaps the question should be, are.
What?
Are wizards more important than witches?
Suit yourself. It'll come out the same in the wash. Two main speakers each. My two best boys versus two of your girls. Drill can be chair. The rest can muck in as they like.
Well, I'm not quite sure.
Of course, we chaps always do better at this sort of thing. But I hope you girls will put up a good fight.
We will, Mr. Helly-boring. We certainly will.
Girls, I know I've told you on countless occasions to remain silent, but now is the time to speak up.
Speak or be done. For too long, we have been ground beneath the well-slippered heel of wizardly one-upmanship.
Thank you, Miss Bat. We're glad to have you with us once more. We need two good speakers.
I think Ethel
Hallow should be one. And Jadu Wali, the other.
Yes. Extreme.
Well done, Jadu.
I know, girls, you normally prefer to argue with each other. But I think in this case, if you were to pitch in together, we might stand a chance of beating the boys!
Yay!
Do you think I'm safe to leave you with this, Mildred?
It's true.
I know. He was beginning to get on my nerves with all those histrionics. I suppose you were just fantasizing about it and your finger slipped.
Something like that.
Have you got everything you need?
Yes, Miss Jo. Oh, Miss Drew, I need my potions book. It's in the... Miss Drew? Oh, rats.
This won't last the afternoon. We'll need more than this, Loppy Lugs.
It's a slow process.
Well, speed it up. You're supposed to be good at potions.
This really is not fair, you
know. Was it fair about the poisonous putrefaction they pour on my plates at lunchtime?
Still taste that liver.
Own goal. I told you not to eat it.
Ah. Word before we start. obvious to you and to me that wizards are, well, superior, but we'll have to pretend it isn't. Start from scratch, so to speak. It's two to a side. Loppy here is first reserve. These lads have got more lip. You've got more ear. Come along, lads.
You wait here and have another dose of that potion ready by afternoon break, or it'll be death for you, Loppy Lugs.
Now then, Loppy Lugs.
Wizards are male and witches are female. Wizards carry staffs and witches ride broomsticks. But they both use potions and spells. However, an expert, intelligent young witch is far more useful than a senseless boy who thinks he's somebody just because he's training to be a wizard. Thank you.
You've got to admit she's good.
She's wiped the floor with them before they've even started. He hasn't a chance.
Gary Grailquest.
A witch is described in the dictionary as a woman who uses magic. A wizard, on the other hand, is defined as a man with extraordinary powers. It is this difference between the ordinary and the extraordinary that marks the distinction between witches and wizards. One might employ a witch to help find a lost pussycat, but to find the rightful heir to the throne, send for a wizard.
Trouble. Big trouble.
Let us examine the case of the legendary King Arthur.
It was you, I know it was.
No.
Twiddling that pencil and everyone's hands shooting up. It was magic, wasn't it? And now you're up to something else, Shifty. Maybe I should pour it away.
Don't, please. They'll kill me.
Will they? I heard you through the door. You said yourself it wasn't fair. Why'd you let them walk all over you?
I don't know.
What are you called? Loppy Legs isn't your real name, is it?
No, it's Merlin.
Merlin.
Arthur pulled the sword from the stone and became King of England. And Merlin the Wizard was there by his side to aid and help him with his wisdom and magic. And if we are to look for a witch in this legend, the only one we shall find is Morgan le Fay, whose jealousy and treachery would one day bring ruin to the land.
Jolly good show. Well done, Grailquest. I never knew you had it in you. What do you say, Hardbroom? Eloquent or what?
Well, thank you, Gary. I think this might be a good moment to call half time. See about some refreshments?
Ah, jolly good. Refreshments, yeah.
I can't.
They wouldn't think twice about telling on you. I know, I'll guess. You don't have to say anything, just listen. I'll know if I'm right with the way you look at me. It's to put in the girls' drinks. No. For them to take. Buzz and gas. To make them more confident. More than that. Speak well and be really clever. Wow, this is some potion.
It certainly is.
Thank you.
I never said a word to her.
It doesn't matter. Nobody's going to believe anything she says. She's as hopeless as you.
And you're coming with us. Well, we can keep an eye on you, blabbermouth.
Come on. Hey, look out!
You stupid idiot! You spilt it!
There's enough in there. Come on, let's get out of here.
Come on.
It's true. Nobody ever believes a word I say. On the other hand, however...
This is real life. Not some legend. Not the old days that wizards are always harking back to. Nowadays, when people want their problems sorted, they go to someone who'll have a cup of tea with them and stroke their cat. Be there for them without all the showing off. Witches are down to earth, when we're not up on our brooms. And that's what makes us the best.
Daddy's put up a jolly good fight. With that fairy dragon thing speaks half as well as his friend. We're done for.
Barry Dragonsbane.
Good luck, old chap.
Oh.
wizards have...
Just a moment. I'd like to ask Barry a question.
Oh, you're supposed to be in your room in solitary confinement.
That is true. But in the interests of truth and justice, even the law itself must be challenged. If I am permitted to put my question, Madam Chair, new evidence pertaining to my so-called crime may well come to light. As Lord Hewitt of the King's Bench once said, justice should not only be done, but should manifestly and undoubtedly be seen to be done.
Good heavens!
Well put, girl. You've been hiding your light under a bushel.
That's an understatement.
You have your say, girl. Liven things up, eh?
But what, Mildred, has all this to do with the relative worth of wizards and witches?
With your permission, Madam Chair, that is something I will now attempt to demonstrate. I do ask, however, that Barry Dragonsbane be denied use of his so-called throat spray until I have finished.
But I've got a cough.
Interesting, don't you think, Madam Chair, that both boys develop a cough just before they begin to speak?
Do continue, Mildred. Ask your question.
These boys will surely claim that wizards are wise men with extraordinary powers entrusted with affairs of state. But what if it could be proved here before us all that some wizards are untrustworthy, deceitful, and treacherous?
Watch what you say.
Yes, she's lying.
I'm asking a question, and I haven't finished asking it yet.
Order! Please continue, Mildred.
What if it could be shown, Madam Chair, that apprentice wizards, invited to take part in a fair contest with young witches, felt that they could not succeed without resort to cheating?
Cheating?
What if, Madam Chair, the purple throat spray on the table at the moment turned out to be a magical potion capable of transforming even a Mildred Hubble into a confident and eloquent public speaker? Wouldn't that mean, as far as today's proceedings are concerned, at least, that witches were the winners?
It most certainly would, Mildred.
Please accept my deepest apologies, Miss Cackle. My abject and humble apologies. Just you wait till I get you back. You'll be squealing a lot more than you are now. I told you they were scallywags, Miss Cackle. But there you are, you see. Boys will be boys.
Yes, Your Honor. And girls will be girls.
Floppy. Thanks.
What do you think the final score was?
For a rule after extra time.
See you again, maybe.
One of these days.